गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन। टुडे आई टेक एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिस्कस एन इंटरेस्टिंग अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन द फील्ड ऑफ कैंसर बायोलॉजी। दैट इज यू नो हाउ कैंसर सेल्स विद इन द ट्यूमर माइक्रो एनवायरनमेंट they adopt in the nature of preferential selection or utilization of certain metabolites. We know, and as per the literature and current understanding, it is true that cancer cells, they go for selection of specific metabolites over other kind of metabolites. And that is why the whole the concept of a choice based selection of metabolites within the tumor cell is very, very important and highly relevant. In other way, we can say the cancer cells within the tumor microenvironment, along with non-cancer cells, and those are actually working for cancer or in favor of cancer cells, and these are most of the time they are referred as cancer associated cells. It can be adipocytes, it can be immune cell, it can be stromal cell, right? So not only cancer cells along with non-cancer cells within the tumor microenvironment, so they develop a sort of choice based selection of metabolites. Then what? There are various types of metabolites, right? It can be carbohydrates, it can be amino acids, it can be fatty acids. So today, my dear friend, I would like to discuss the whole idea of how the free fatty acids within the tumor microenvironment, where the cancer cells are there, non-cancer cells are there, these free fatty acids, they are not preferred. So here is the whole twist. Those metabolites, those are liked or preferred by the cancer cells. Definitely, they are going to help cancer cell for growth, proliferation, or you can say resistance during the drug treatment. But here the whole point is the free fatty acids are not liked by or selected by the cancer cells. Instead of the free fatty acids are going to be excluded. They are not, I mean, cancer cells, they do not prefer to allow them to enter and inside the compartment, or you can say the intracellular side. That is the whole interesting point is. Then whole question comes why the cancer cell are not going to prefer or select free fatty acids. It is very important. And those are listening to this particular video, they have to understand we are not talking about the lipid, we are talking about the free fatty acids. That means if you consider the lipid as a macromolecule, that is having the glycerol and fatty acids. So we are talking about those free fatty acids, those are going to come from during the degradation of lipids within the tissue microenvironment. And that is the whole point is how cancer cell, why cancer cell are not going to prefer or allow the entry of free fatty acids within the intracellular compartment, right? Fine. So in that direction today, I would like to give you the model or the proposed model why free fatty acids are not suitable for cancer cells. Fine. So let me to go to the next slide here. Yes. So let me to give to a good explanation. Look at here, my dear friend. If you know the tumors are various types. So the whole question is also, whenever I say a particular tumor, they have you can say preferences for a particular metabolites, or sometimes we use the word here, if I can spell out, these are the onco metabolites, right? So that means some of the metabolites that can work as a onco-metabolites for certain type of the tumor. So what is the whole story? One type of the tumor, they have one set of onco-metabolites. Other type of the tumor, they may have other type of onco-metabolites. Inversely, we can say, one type of the cancer cell or the tumor, they may prefer one metabolites over other. Other type of the tumor may prefer one type of the metabolites over the other metabolites. That means, very simply what I mean here, that is metabolic heterogeneity. So there is a metabolic heterogeneity from one type of the tumor to the another type of the tumor, right? So now, let us go to the understanding. So today I'm going to show the relevance, and it is more specific to the breast tumor or breast cancer. Because the whole story of the free fatty acid not preferred by cancer cell is more specific to the particular tumor, that is here, breast tumor. So my dear friend, if you look at here, so whole this particular area, you know, all the model here, this refers the breast tumor microenvironment, right? So here is the breast cancer cells. Here is, importantly, there are non-cancer cells. For an example, I will quote here, adipocytes are there, right? So the cancer cells are there, adipocytes are there. And we know that, you know, some of the, you know, the concept is the adipocytes within the tumor microenvironment, they are referred as cancer-associated adipocytes. That means these adipocytes, not simple adipocytes, they are actually pro-tumor, pro-cancer. They support cancer cell for what? For the growth and proliferation and various other hallmark of the cancer cells. Great. So look at here, the stories here. So we know that adipocytes, they have the capability of lipolysis of lipid molecule. So look at here. So these lipid molecules are going to be degraded within the adipocytes through the lipolysis. And then due to the degradation of the lipid, what is happening? Glycerols are going to be generated and free fatty acid. That is what our interest is here. Now the twist is here. Cancer cells close to the adipocytes, they are going to have the preferences for glycerol. Look at here. Not free fatty acids, this one. So that means the cancer cell are going to allow the more efficient entry of glycerol within the cytoplasmic side, and the free fatty acids are going to be preferentially not selected, right? Look at here. Low uptake possibilities are there. Great. So once the glycerol is going to enter inside the intracellular compartment of the cancer cells, so that will participate within the high glycolysis. And my dear friend, if all of us are aware, the cancer cells, they have one of the hallmark, that is of high glycolysis. Through the glycolysis, they generate most of the required number of ATP molecule, that is your currency or energy currency. And then, you know, the whole cancer cell, they are going to be in a high proliferation, high growth stage, that is the pro-tumor metabolic needs. Great. Now we will go to the other aspect. Once the lipid is going to be degraded, free fatty acids are also generated. Look at here. So these free fatty acid within the tumor microenvironment, that is in the ECF, like extracellular fluid, if I consider, here is the cancer cell membrane. So these area are the ECF. So in the ECF, free fatty acids are going to be released or generated, because cancer cell are not going to accept these free fatty acids like glycerol. And another very important is, if the cancer patient or any individual, they are going to have the diets in the form of the lipid or lipid-rich diet, what is happening? The possibilities are the diet or dietary lipids, they are also going to be degraded, or you can say the fragmented. So the dietary lipids, they are also going to go into the two form, glycerol and the fatty acids, right? So along with the, you know, the adipocytes generated free fatty acids, the possibilities are very clear. The free fatty acids and the glycerol are also going to be generated from the dietary lipid sources. This is what the point, right? Very good. So either from the diet or the adipocytes, what is the whole idea? Glycerols are going to enter inside the cell, right? Inside the cancer cells, and then pro-tumor metabolic requirements are going to be fulfilled. But free fatty acids are not preferred by cancer cell. The question is why? Why these free fatty acids, if you look at here, they are not going to be entered inside the cancer cell, rather than they are in the ECF or the outside of the cell. And that is why in a recent observation, even in my lab, it's also very novel in the aspect. These free fatty acids, if you look at here, they are accumulated in cancer patients. And these high abundance and the secretion of free fatty acids are going to be detected in the biological fluids, or you can say even in the nil material of cancer patient. In recently our lab, we have also proposed the idea of NILS along with urine, saliva, or the serum can serve the purpose for biomarker detection. So the possibilities of free fatty acids in the biological fluids or the nail of breast cancer patient is logical, based on the preferential selection of metabolites by the cancer cells. And that is why free fatty acids are going to be detected as a biomarker in the biological fluids. So it is itself new, and it can be helpful if we can have the, you know, a set of free fatty acids. Those are specific to, like, you know, breast cancer patients, and it can be detected, then in future that can serve as a part of you can say diagnostic purpose in case of breast cancer patient. That is as a free fatty acids. Great. Another I would like to have the attention, free fatty acids, if it is going to be generated more in the ECF within the tumor microenvironment, then it can also lead to the acidic tumor microenvironment. The pH can be decreased. And here the important point is, so it is also, you know, well understood that the tumor microenvironment is acidic in nature, and the acidic tumor microenvironment is in favor of cancer. So what is the conclusion here? If you look at glycerol is going to be preferred by the cancer cell in favor of cancer, right? Free fatty acids is not going to enter inside the cell, is in favor of cancer cells. Then acidic environment within the tumor is in favor of cancer cells. So all together, if you look at here, this tumor microenvironment, or specifically breast tumor microenvironment, the choice based selection of glycerol over free fatty acid is going to work in favor of cancer cell, including adipocytes, that is working as cancer associated adipocytes. Right? Great. So based on these understanding, there are some questions are generated that can be very, very useful in near future. So what is the question here? Let me go to the next slide. Yeah. So here is the questions. What I think can be useful. So the question is whether cocktail of free fatty acids. So what we are proposing as a COFFA, C-O-F-F-A, cocktail of free fatty acids can be a good option to arrest breast cancer cells. Can be used as an anti-proliferative, or, you know, a sort of, we can say, mechanism or the approach to arrest the growth and proliferation of the breast cancer cell. So it looks logical based on the understanding. Another is, you know, whether cocktail of free fatty acids, once they are, if they are going to enter inside the cell by some mechanism or by some ways, whether can inhibit the cell cycle progression proteins like, you know, cyclin or cyclin dependent kinases, etc. And third question is relevant. It's very surprising and bizarre that whether free fatty acid compositions varies from human to the ruminant. Ruminant, if I consider like cow, goat, buffalo, lion, tiger, etc. So whether the free fatty acids composition are different in case of human and different in case of cow, goat, etc. If it is true, then indirectly it can prove the idea of the whole idea is genotumor heterogeneity. That means if I say the occurrence of breast tumor in human, occurrence of breast tumor in goat, occurrence of breast tumor in cow or any other ruminants are going to be differential. There are clinical data that, you know, the breast tumor in cow is rare, breast tumor in goat is rare. So whether the possibilities are there, the free fatty acid compositions in the biological fluids of cow, goat, or other ruminants are unique, are distinctive. And these free fatty acids availability within the biological fluids of these ruminants are potentially are able to, you can say, slow down, or you can say exclude the chance of certain type of the cancer, and specifically like breast cancer. However, it needs investigation, and our lab is also understanding and exploiting the possibilities of this cocktail of fatty acids, COFA, whether they can work as some sort of anti-proliferative drug regimens for certain type of breast cancer patients. I'm thankful to Professor Sachin Sarode for timely and very insightful discussion on certain aspect of cancer biology. Thank you very much for listening to this particular video, and I'm sure that it will help you and it will give you better understanding about the why cancer cells are different from normal cells. Thank you very much for all of you. Take care, stay blessed.